Hello everyone. Today I will show you how to create a simple classic bundle in Bundler app. I will create a bundle which will give my customers a 10% discount when they buy two products together. After you open the Bundler app, you will first see all of the bundles that you have configured. And above that is a button which you can use to create a new bundle in your shop. I will click it and a pop-up will appear where I will select the type of bundle I want to create. You can see that I can now select the type of bundle I want to create. Currently, you can create classic bundle, mix and match bundle, and a volume discount bundle. The classic bundle is a bundle where you give customers a discount when they buy a preset combination of products. The Mix and Match bundle allows customers to pick any combination of products from the bundle and get a discount as long as they fulfill the requirements you set up. The Volume discount allows you to give customers a discount when they buy multiples of the same or different products together. For example, you can give them a discount when they buy four of the same items together. We will explain the last two in another video. In my case, I want to create a classic bundle where I will give my customers a discount when they buy specific products together. For this, I will select the first option where it says classic bundle. So let's continue by clicking on the classic bundle option. All right, we are now configuring our classic bundle. As you can see, each field already has a default value. In most cases, the default values are good enough, but we will check each of them so that you will know what they mean. The first field allows us to set up the name of the bundle. In my case, I will change it to Simple Classic Bundle. This name will show up in the checkout page as the name of the discount. The second field gives you an option to set a title for this bundle. This title will show up in your shop and on your product pages. I will just leave it on the default option, as the default value is already okay for me. The next option allows you to set up a description for this bundle discount. This will show just below the title of the bundle in the bundle widget. This default option is good enough for me, so I will just leave it how it is. The third option is the pricing info, which will show up just above the Add to Cart button in the bundle. I will show you how this shows in the widget later in the video. I will leave the default values in here, as these two placeholders will be automatically replaced with the correct value in the widget itself. In most cases, you don't have to edit this field at all. This input field defines what will show in the Add to Cart button of the bundle widget. And this field defines the text which shows below the Add to Cart button. You can see that it basically explains to the customer that the discount for this bundle will be applied at the checkout, which is great. All right, so now we are at the priority sequence. The priority sequence is a great functionality, which is incredibly useful when you have multiple bundles with similar sets of products. Here is how this works. By default, Bundler applies bundle discounts by bundle's priority sequence, meaning that it first tries to apply a discount from a bundle with the highest priority, and so on. If every bundle has a unique combination of products, then you don't even have to bother with a priority sequence. However, as soon as you have the same or a similar combination in more than one bundle, for example, bundle with products A and B and another bundle with products A, B, and C, then you have to set the priority of your bundles. If you want to keep using both bundles in this example, then the second bundle, the one with more products, should have a higher priority than the first one. This way, Bundler first tries to apply the discount from the bundle with the higher priority, and if it can't apply it because the customer doesn't have all of the required products in the cart, then it continues with the next bundle. As we will create one bundle, I will just leave this on its default value. All right, now to the next option. The bundle status allows you to set up whether the bundle is active or paused. When the bundle is active, the Bundler app will apply bundle discounts. But when the bundle is paused, the Bundler app won't apply the bundle discount. Simple as that. This option on the right allows us to set if we want to show the widgets for this bundle and where we want to show them. We can set the app to show the widgets, hide them everywhere, or hide them just on the product pages. A thing to note here is that even if we hide the widgets for this bundle, Bundler will still apply discounts from this bundle as long as the customers have the correct products in their carts. Okay, the next setting allows us to limit the bundle discount only to customers tagged with a specific tag. You can use this functionality to show the widget and apply discounts only to wholesale customers, members of your club, and so on. I will leave it empty as I want to offer this bundle discount to all customers in my shop. The next option allows us to schedule the bundle discount. Let's take a look. More settings show up, and now I can set the date and time from which the bundle will be active and the date and time when the bundle offer will expire. After you select the date and time, just click the Select button to confirm your selection. I have now configured the date and time when the bundle should become active and the date and time when the bundle should expire, so you can see how to configure this. But for our tutorial here, I want to have the bundle active all the time, so I will just uncheck this option and reset the schedule. As I uncheck this option, the bundle will start working immediately after I save it. And on to the next section. In this next section, we can decide what kind of a discount we want to offer to our customers. We can create a bundle with a percentage discount, fixed amount discount. We can set specific discount on some of the products in the bundle, or we can simply set a fixed bundle price. In this tutorial, we will simply give customers a 10% discount. You can also give your customers a free shipping discount when they buy a bundle. To do this, just check this box here. And let's move on. In this next section, we can set the bundle product level. This is an incredibly useful functionality, which allows us to separate variants in the bundle or keep them grouped under the same products. For example, the default product level option will leave the variants of the same product grouped in a drop-down selector. This is, of course, only applicable if your products in the bundle have more than just one variant. And the other variant level option allows us to display each variant as a standalone product in the bundle. This means that each variant we add to the bundle will show up as its own product, and the customer will have to buy them all to get the bundle discount. This is incredibly useful if you want to give customers a discount when they buy variant A and variant B together, even if these two variants both belong to the same product. Also, variant level bundles allow you to set up a custom image which can show up instead of all products in the bundle. In this tutorial, we will leave this on the default product level value. And on to the most important part, the discounted products in the bundle. This is where we select the actual products which we want to have in the bundle. These are the products which the customer will have to buy together to get a bundle discount. To select products, just click the Select Products button. And now, we just select the products we want to have in the bundle and click Add button. You can now also see that we can set a specific quantity for each product in the bundle. You can see that you can set this up here. And we can even set a custom image for each product. By default, the Bundler app will take the product or variant image and show it for this product in the widget. But you can override this with this option and set a custom product image. The option where it says automatically add new product variants is useful if you regularly add new variants to your products. If you turn on this option, then the app will detect this and automatically add these newly created variants to this bundle. This saves you some time, as you won't have to come back to the app and add the new variants to the bundle. I will turn this on. These next two sections are a bit more advanced. They allow you to configure discount conditions and display the bundle widgets on any page in your app. We will skip those in this tutorial and explain it in another one. The last section here is the one where we can set up a custom bundle landing page content. Bundles in Bundler app come with automatically generated bundle landing pages. These pages have unique URLs which you can use to promote your bundles in emails, websites, and so on. And in here, we can set up a custom content for this landing page. For now, I won't yet add any custom landing page content. All right, this is great. We are almost done. And now to save the bundle, you just click this Save Bundle button. All right, this is now saved. I will scroll back up and check out the bundle's landing page. You can see that two new buttons appeared here. The first one allows me to get a link to the automatically generated landing page, while the other one allows me to get the quick checkout link, which can be used to lead my customers directly to the checkout. For now, I will use the landing page URL to see how the bundle shows up. Okay, you can see how nicely the bundle shows up in my shop. You can see the title which I set up on the bundle, the description, the products with images, the discounted price, product variants, and so on. And to add the bundle to the cart and get the discount, I just click this Add to Cart button. All right, and you can see that the discount is also applied on the checkout. You can see that both the 10% discount and the free shipping discount were applied on this order, which is great. Just the way I configured the bundle. One more thing. I also wanted to show you that the bundle widget also automatically shows on the product pages of the relevant products in your shop. I can see the bundle just below the product description. The bundle widget can, of course, also be moved to a different location, but let's leave this for another tutorial. All right, that's it. In the video that you just watched, you learned how to create a simple classic bundle in the Bundler app. You learned how to configure the bundle, set the discount, select the products, and how to check how and if the bundle widget shows up. I hope that you liked the video and that it helped you clear any doubts you might have had. Now, open the Bundler app in your shop and configure your first bundle. Have a great day!